Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Friday the 14th of September 2018. Standard fare is, well, the fires are going out anyway, that's what we can say about the rain right now, but boy has it ever cooled off. You could probably check the weather and stuff around the local area here, local, you know, within 1,000 kilometers or 500 kilometers, like up Edmonton way. Snow, Grand Prairie snow, Calgary snow, Fort St. John snow. Now, having said that, that's more north than where we are here. Calgary isn't far north, but Calgary's kind of like Denver. Calgary's very, very high up in its altitude. You go on Google Maps or Google Earth and it gives you the altitude and you'll see how high Calgary is. So, I mean, from what I've been told, I've never lived in Calgary, just listened to people talk to me about Calgary, and they said, you know, it snows in the summer sometimes, you know, you just get a dusting. But anyway, but weather anomalies all over here, it's cold, summer is over, it was down to about close to freezing last night, you know, within a couple degrees anyway, centigrade, but you know, it's raining right now. It's gonna get colder. Anyway, got my wool jammies on. This is an old Parkway. Parkway. I don't know if it's real wool or synthetic wool. You know, I couldn't care less. The label's gone. But it's really warm, but fluffy. And completely useless in a dry suit when it gets wet, because it just, you weigh 1,000 pounds. That's why they went to that black one I wear. It's that Coke bottle material, it's recycled something or other, but it's very warm, but it doesn't breathe as well, but it doesn't soak up the water like other things, and it's very thin, whereas this is much thicker, but this one gives me the better comfy feeling. The feet are still attached, but they're completely done in, but this is old. I think this Parkway jammy, well, Parkway split entry dry suit, if you guys can remember that, go through and all the way up the back. Now they're mostly back entries or side zippers. But back in the day, it was a split suit and you get in it and then you zip from underneath. Anyway, it was interesting. But technology's come a long way in diving as well. I'm really happy to see that. But anyway, enough about that. Get my Parkway on. Still haven't put the heat on, but it came on a little while back, but I turned it down even more so it won't come on until it gets really cold. So, but yeah, I was just going through Florence. Talk about Florence really quickly. I was doing the internets last night, looking at all the live feeds from Wilmington area and down there, and came ashore last night. I was watching it for a while. And, you know, I'm not going to stay up all night just to watch the hurricane. So, you know, prayers to everybody down there. It seemed to have been downgraded or really, really weakened as it came ashore. And I just checked now and it just seems to be kind of like circling. Still pretty powerful. I didn't check any live feeds. I just went on and just to check, you know, where it is, you know, what's going on. But a lot of potential problems from it. I saw a couple little headlines really quickly about flooding, you know, people trapped, surging, stuff like that. I hope everybody took proper precautions. Like, if you knew it was coming, either to get out, and if you're going to hole up because you had things that you couldn't leave, then I hope you took proper precautions that, you know, you can be in a disaster area as long as you've done your math. You know, it's just the way it is. I mean, I know hurricanes are nasty. I can vaguely remember Africa, and I'm just going to say tropical storm. I was a kid, you know, I was like 10 years old. It was 1970-something. And I can remember one time in the Navy being coming back from Boston. You know, we always used to go to Boston from Halifax. It was an easy, it's a really quick, quick bebop down to Boston for the weekend or whatever. And it was 1986, and I can't remember if it was a hurricane or it was a depression, but it was nasty, and it was a stern sea. I think I mentioned it before, guys that normal guys that have been in the Navy for a long time, and we were in a small gate boat. We weren't in a large naval vessel. We were in a small gate boat, very, very tiny in comparison to large naval vessels. It was basically a gate vessel, cable layer, chain layer. We had been refitted for the reserve, and I was in the reserve back then, so we went down to Boston. But anyway, the hurricane was nasty, and we wanted to beat the hurricane back, and we didn't make it. We got stern seas. We didn't get beaten up too bad when we limped in. Things were broken. Like, pieces of machinery that were bolted to the walls and stuff were ripped off the wall. Not completely torn off and thrown on the deck, but, you know, things had bent and moved in metal world, and when you're twisting metal at sea, it's always bad. So, you know, there was guys who had a lot of sea time. I was lucky. I was ignorant. I was young, and I didn't know any better that our lives were in that much danger, so I didn't care. I thought it was just a great amusement park ride. But anyway, enough about hurricane. I think it was hurricane... Oh, a tropical depression or a hurricane. 86. Summer of 86. I can't remember. So, I don't want to say. I can't remember the name or anything. So, anyway, I'd have to check through on the internet. I'm sure they have it listed. Okay, what else do we have to talk about? The two Bs. We'll talk about Bezos, and we'll talk about the demise, or what I just saw. That's one thing about being an adult. You can afford crap like this, you know? These are metal, and it all works. You know, the steering wheel turns the wheels, and this opens up and everything, you know? As an adult, you can buy junk like this, you know? As a kid, you know, these are too expensive, and you'd break it, it would be smashed. But yeah, sad note, the Beatle, although I don't really count the new V-dub, you know, the new ones when they came out, when they redid it, those in my opinion are not Volkswagens, they're just a car that looked like a Volkswagen. The Beatle in itself, Herbie the Love Bug, I mean, that's the Beatle. My grandfather, that's all he ever owned. He was a bit of a, I could be wrong, but I think he was a bit of a socialist, coal miner. He knew Tommy Douglas. I'm pretty sure, yeah, that's what Mom told me, that he knew Tommy Douglas. I believe Tommy Douglas could be called the father of healthcare for Canada, I imagine, or one of them, or whatever. Could be wrong. Going from memory. But the Beetle, that's all he drove because it was a reliable vehicle, and I think he had three of them in his life. You know, poor coal miner, and it was something that you could afford. And the thing about, I remember about the Beetle is, from my grandpa's Beetle, the window area, because he would chew tobacco, and it was the plug. He'd chew the plug, right? And he'd always be constantly, and it would be on the deck. It wouldn't be in a can or a bottle. It would be right out the window. And right on the deck, no matter where it was. So, you know, this is the 60s and the 70s, right? He passed away early. He passed away in the 70s. But fond memories of Grandpa and the VW. And we've got pictures of it and everything like that. But that's all he drove. The only thing I can say about the VW, when you've got it fully loaded, in those days, they didn't go very fast. We got pulled over once, and I can remember the cop giving Grandpa a ticket for going too slow. He was a hazard on the road. You just picture one of these things filled with, there was me, my brother, my cousins, grandpa, grandma. I'm going to say the car had to have about 7 or 8 people in it. You know, before rules, you know. Before the shoulder belts, just lap belt. You know, there was no rules. You could have kids sitting on the roof. Who cared? You know, you're going too slow. If you want to drive with that many people on it, speed up. Just funny stuff like that. But really sad to hear that the Beatles being... you know, just, but there again, you know, a sign of the times, you know, changes and everything like that. Just for me, it would be sad, you know. I always liked the Beetle. I always had a soft spot in my heart for the Beetle, the VW Bug. Herbie the Love Bug, 53. Anyway, rest in peace. And we'll just quickly end with Bezos. And I wanted to talk about Bezos because I just was going through something this morning really quickly, and then... It talks about the rich guy who's got $100 billion and he's going to try and help the homeless and everything like that. And he said, you know, just a real snippet. And look, okay, it's his money. And I'm not here to say that he should do this with his money or he should do that with his money. All I can say is that if I had $100 billion, come on, look. Look at what $100 billion is. Look at what $100 billion could do. Look at how many people in the look at how many people on this planet are that filthy rich. You wonder why there's strife and anger and everything on the planet? And here again, I'm not trying to say that this guy should do whatever. It's not my business, but crap. A lot of problems could be solved. That's all I can say. A lot of problems can be solved. You know, like how much do you need? $100 billion is... There's 1,000 millions for every billion. So you have 100,000 millions? Holy cow. And then once again, you know, people will rail on me. So, what's this money do? You want to get burned? You can shit. Okay. But it is a bit obscene when you think about it. $100 billion? $100 billion. Take 99, give 99 away. Keep a billion for yourself. That's still 1,000 millions. It's just obscene. It's at the level of obscenity. It's an obscenity. It's obscene. And that, once again, it's his money. Yes, I understand that. You know, I can go back and forth on whether he earned it or not or whatever, what have you. I don't care. It's obscene, that amount of money for one person to have is obscene. You know, good luck with trying to give it away. I mean, do you remember Brewster's Millions? What a joke! I think the premise of the Brewster's Millions is that he was trying to give away 30 million in order to inherit 300 million. And this guy think and we're having problems, or think we have problems, or he's trying to figure out, or he's trying to do something for the homeless with $100 billion? It doesn't even make sense. It doesn't even make sense. I know that sounds a bit of a rant, and I can even feel myself getting a bit emotional about it. Sorry. But holy crap, it's just $100 billion is obscene. You know. How much do you need for yourself? I mean, you know. I don't know. It just seems obscene. It just seems obscene. That's all. I mean, what else can I say? Anyway, I'll shut up because I'm ranting about it. So anyway, good luck with trying to figure out how to give it away there, Mr. Bezos. I wish I had your problem, because I can promise you I'd be on it right now. And all the homeless in this town wouldn't have any problem. I don't care if it's not solving the problem. Give them a home. Okay, it isn't, but give them a home anyway. You know, if you burn it down around them, or, you know, fill their body with drugs afterwards and they die, well, I did what I could. You know, or whatever. I mean, you know. Anyway, sorry about that little bit of ranty. Weekend's coming up. Back's back to normal. A week of hell. Up and down, really. But anyway, peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.